Hello everyone, welcome you all to our YouTube channel Pragyan Sportyfitz, and I am Simanta Chatterjee, your physical and psychological fitness instructor. So guys and girls, in today's session I am going to discuss a serious topic, and this is all about thyroid gland and hypothyroid problem. So without making any delay, let's start with the topic now. So what is thyroid gland all about? So thyroid gland, it's a butterfly shaped gland available in our throat, in this area, this section. And this thyroid gland is very, very essential, and it has a couple of functions. So what are the necessity of thyroid gland? Thyroid gland regulates metabolic rate. Thyroid gland also look after muscle growth, bone health, brain development, mood maintenance, heart and digestive functions. Thyroid gland plays a very vital function to run our body perfectly. Now, what are the method, how it functions? Let's focus on that. Now the question is, how thyroid gland or how thyroid works? Very simple. In our brain, pituitary gland releases TSH hormone, or thyroid stimulating hormone, and this thyroid stimulating hormone send a signal to the thyroid gland to release T3 and T4. Now if our body needs more T3 and T4, then TSH hormone, then pituitary gland will release more TSH hormone just to inform our thyroid gland to release more T3 and T4. If we need less T3 and T4, then pituitary gland will control over the TSH hormone, and that's how it works, and that's how it controls the entire functionalities. So if you ask me, what's the good T3 or T4 or TSH level according to the medical status, there is a table. T3, it should be 0.60 to 1.81 nanogram per deciliter. T4, 5.01 to 12.45 microgram per deciliter. TSH, 0.42, 4.0 international unit per liter. If thyroid report comes under this in medical, they take it as normal, okay? But if there is anything that beyond the limit or that under the limit, it known as disorder. And now the question is, how that disorder happens? So the thing is, when you have more TSH and less T3 and T4, that is known as hypothyroid disorder or hypothyroidism. When your TSH hormone is less, but T3 and T4 hormone is more than the standard, it is known as hyperthyroid disorder or hyperthyroidism. And these are the very common thing. It happens, and there are a couple of symptoms. So since we are going to discuss hypothyroidism, so we will explain everything. What are the symptoms if someone is having hypothyroidism or hypothyroid disorder? And the symptoms are deep voice, disturbed menstrual cycle, dry skin, hair fall, mood change, depression, constipation, less sleep, joint pain, tiredness, and weak nerve system. In hypothyroid condition, our metabolic rate comes down, and if metabolic rate comes down, then our body gain much weight. Because of all this thing, people are suffering from hypothyroidism, they gain weight. Now, just to get rid of this problem, there should be some solution, and the solution is nutrition. Your medicines will not work until or unless you focus on your nutritional thing. And nowadays, many people, they only focus on medicines and not on nutrition. So what will happen? You are going to continue purchasing medicines, you are going to consume all these things, and down the line there will be no solution. Nothing wrong with consuming medicines, but you need to focus on your nutrition too. Now, here I am going to give you some information about what food you need to eat and what food you need to ignore. So, you need to have whole grains, oats, brown rice, quinoa, chickpeas, black chana, kidney beans, lentils, carrot, bottle gourd, tomatoes, capsicum, seaweeds, banana, jackfruit, pineapple, muskmelon, pomegranate, and citrus foods like orange, lemon, etc. Olive oil, coconut oil, pure deshi ghee, fish oil, walnut, almonds, pumpkin seeds, Brazil nut, flax seeds, yogurt, low fat milk, cottage cheese, buttermilk, egg, chicken, salmon fish if you are non-vegetarian. If you talk about the spices, then we have cinnamon, turmeric, coriander, garlic, ginger, black pepper. So all these are things, it will improve your thyroid gland's functionality. So, and you need iodized salt, not table salt. So all those foods having a good amount of nutrients and iodines. So if you have iodines, then it will help you to function your thyroid gland better, and it will improve the secretion of T3 and T4 hormone very well. Now here are a couple of foods you need to ignore. That is processed item, and then high oily item, cruciferous vegetables like cauliflower, cabbage, and then we have broccoli, spinach, kale, soy foods, anything like soybean, soy chunk, soy milk, everything you need to ignore, because those things will spoil your thyroid functionality. Okay, so please stick to the diet and ignore all these things and follow proper medications, you will be all right. So medication and diet, both important, right? And one more thing, you have to do a couple of exercises. So these are very very basic exercises, cardiovascular exercises, and this thing will improve your body functionality, and it will improve your metabolic rate as well, because more exercise with it will improve your metabolic rate, and if you improve your metabolic rate, then definitely it will help you to burn more fat. So your diet will improve your thyroid functionality, your exercise will help you to burn more fat, your medication will give you extra support, and by this thing definitely your thyroid disorder will be under control, or it can be cured, right? So that's all guys, this is all about the information about thyroid. I hope you got some information, and if you like this video, please hit the like button, and if you are first time visitor of our YouTube channel, please subscribe our YouTube channel, share this video, because this is a medical condition and people should know what to do, right? And finally, thank you very much for all of your support. Visit our Facebook page as well and follow that. I am also in Instagram, even you can follow me over there, right? So finally, thank you very much to all of you. Namaskar, Jai Hind.